everyone, welcome back to Project Happy Home. For those of you who are new here, I'm Tanya, a doctor lawyer turned homeschool mom of three kids ages 10, 7, and 5. In today's video, I will be showing you a little bit more about Math Mammoth for grade 1. If you're interested in videos about secular homeschooling, particularly resources like this, raising a child with ADHD, and living a more essentialist lifestyle, you have come to the right place, so be sure to hit that subscribe button down below the video. As I said, in today's video, I'll be going over the inside of Math Mammoth's grade 1 books. Now, we started using Math Mammoth for the first time last year, and I have been so impressed with how my children have evolved in math skills since we started this program. In particular, their math facts have become much more solid, and their skill with math fluency, just interpreting and analyzing word problems, has increased dramatically. And I love this program, and I fully expect to be using it for several years to come. When you get Math Mammoth, you have several different options. You can buy set workbooks, or you can actually buy the PDF and just print them out. So I actually had this printed by, I think, the homeschool printing company. And this year for second grade and for fourth grade, I just printed them myself and bound them. It works out really well. I purchased mine through Homeschool Buyers Co-op, and I got an excellent deal for grades 1 through 7. I think it was under $140. I think this is an excellent, excellent curriculum for math, and you really can't beat the price and the comprehensive nature of it. It is both mastery and spiral in a way, and you'll see what I mean as I get into it. You'll notice that these are labeled work texts, and that is because this is the entire curriculum. They include both workbook material and textbook material in the same exact printout. So the topics covered in grade 1 range from addition, concept and facts between 0 and 10, subtraction between 0 and 10, the connection between addition and subtraction, graphs, two-digit numbers and place value to 100, and then again a review of addition and subtraction facts, clock and calendar, shapes and measuring, adding and subtracting to 100, and counting coins. So really a pretty comprehensive first grade math curriculum. When you open the curriculum, you'll notice there's a clear table of contents. There's also a foreword that explains how it's organized. Every single chapter starts out with a little summary of what's on what page. So one of the first things you'll notice is this curriculum prints in full color. It's really bright and engaging. It starts off with a review of kindergarten work and then moves into chapter 1 with more addition and subtraction facts. If you'll notice, the boxes that are outlined in blue are actually the textbook boxes. So that's where some of the teaching is. And the other colors show you where the work is. She has highlighting printed out so that the student knows what to focus on and what the answer might be. And as we move on through chapter 1, you'll see that she's building on the student's skills. So right now she's doing number line addition. There's very clear instruction that if your child is not familiar with numbers greater than 10, you can skip these for now. So it addresses the fact that different children might be at different places when it comes to number sense. I regard this program as both mastery and spiral because she has quite a few concepts to solidify math facts, but then as she moves on, she revisits that concept later when she's dealing with something else. So for example, here we're working on greater than or less than, but then we come back to addition here. Particularly in the early levels, there's a lot of review. She introduces word problems in a very clear fashion at this age. I like that she provides workspace for them, and that she has the textbook section right there on the page so they can look up easily and refer to how they would do this. There's a lot of matching of different types of addition problems and subtraction problems to one answer, and that gives students the idea that, you know, you can create the same sum from different combinations of add-ins. The beginning of every single chapter has a little introduction about how you might want to teach it, how you might want to approach the symbols, etc. There's also a clear table of contents and then helpful resources on the internet. So if you want to supplement the workbook, you can totally play these computer games. There's some printable games that you can print out. I love the extra things that she provides in Math Mammoth. So it's definitely not a straight workbook program. As you go into subtraction, again, the student sees familiar things like number lines to solidify those concepts. And then it goes on where she uses a lot of graphics to illustrate these concepts. There's a lot of one-to-one addition and subtraction where you can practice just writing lines to understand how many more or less something has. And as you go on, you can see that she usually has a combination of different types of problems within any given lesson. She introduces concepts like bar graphs and Venn diagrams, different types of grouping when she teaches place value, a hundreds chart here, word numbers here, greater than or less than. She also has a section on tallying, I believe. There's more bar graph problems. There's always a review at the end of every chapter before the test. Now, I'm not actually showing you the tests here. I printed them out in a different book, and it's actually already filed away for my daughter's records. But basically, I printed out the tests in a separate file so that I could save them. These workbooks won't be saved, so I wanted them to be in a different section. So I'm just going to quickly flip through the 1B work text to show you so that you get an idea of what kinds of things students cover. So again, you have addition and subtraction, greater than or less than. Every few sections, she will pop in a puzzle corner, and that's basically a more challenging conceptual problem that causes them to have to think a little bit harder. So for example, here, you have to find the numbers that'll work so that these boxes work both vertically and horizontally. So it just introduces a little complexity to their thinking. Again, at the beginning of every chapter, you have the introduction and then several helpful resources. So for example, for time, she has two full pages of different types of days of the week's game, month games, creating your own calendar, a calendar song, flashcard clocks, memory games, so many different things that you could print out. And all the links are right there for you. For example, this is a YouTube video. Here's a math nook site, a math game site. I like how visual all of her time teaching is. And when she goes to an hour later and everything, it works out really well. She also talks about time order and sequencing of things, the difference between evening and daytime, how to find calendar dates, how to correlate that with the day of the week. Sometimes, especially for math, I don't require my students to write out everything because I like to save their writing for writing so that things don't get tiring. So I'll just write orally and we just do these out loud. And sometimes, like, I will write things down for them if they're feeling a little bit reluctant or a little bit grumpy that day. And that's an easy way of getting through your lessons without necessarily forcing the issue. Now in my, fourth year of homeschooling, I definitely don't fight about those little things. Like, my main goal is that they understand the concept and that we can move on that way. So you'll see there's lots of different shapes and patterns in chapter 6. There's measuring of actual objects as well as objects on a page. And as you keep going, there's a two-digit addition being introduced. So you have a two-digit number plus another number, no carrying yet, but just to get people comfortable with where you put numbers in the tens column, the ones column, etc. One of the things that you'll see repeated often in Math Mammoth are lists like this. So where you have continue the pattern, and that allows the student to observe that when you start with the same number and you subtract a higher number every time, this is going to go down by one as well. So that type of idea is repeated often. I like that she uses the 10 blocks and the 1 blocks to show addition. If you're familiar with Math UC or any other program that uses rods for counting, that's a nice time to incorporate that as well. As you keep going on, you'll see that it gets more complicated, but again, the format stays the same. You have this little text box here that does the teaching, and then you have a very colorful array for different types of problems. She likes to do this a lot as well, where she'll have like a chain of addition or subtraction, and then you have some mixed review. So here you have your sort of spiral review, right, where it will have not just concepts from this chapter, but concepts from a previous chapter as well. They introduce concepts like 1/4, 2/2, 3/4 by the end of first grade. You have pictographs, you have a big review, and then, like I said here, we were going to have a test right after that review section. The coin section is also in full color. I love the graphics that she uses to describe equivalence for coins, and it's just a really nice first grade math curriculum where you go through and you hit basically everything you would want to hit in a first grade math curriculum. So if you are interested in a self-contained, comprehensive math curriculum that is inexpensive, that teaches math facts and math concepts really well, almost like a combination of Saxon and Singapore math, I think Math Mammoth is a great option for you. I'm really, really happy with it. We definitely will be sticking with it through seventh grade. Now, do my kids enjoy Math Mammoth? it is not their favorite thing to do, partly because it has so much math fact practice, and I'm okay with that because I feel like every lesson isn't that long. We don't always complete every lesson. We generally shift between 2 to 4 pages per lesson, depending on the length of any given page. And I've been so impressed with their growth in math that I am committed to sticking this out. I think that as somebody who has used Singapore Math and other programs, that this is really bang for your buck, the best value you could get. And it is so comprehensive and well done. There are videos online where she explains concepts as well, if you want to have a little video instruction for your kids. So I just love it. I think it's amazing. If you have any questions about Math Mammoth, please don't hesitate to ask me in the comments down below. And let me know if you have any experience with the higher grade levels of it, because I definitely intend to use 3rd grade and 5th grade next year for my daughter and my son. And then my youngest will be using this, and I'll just print it out again because I have the PDFs forever. I hope that was helpful to you guys. As always, I really do value your time. Thank you for spending some of it with me, and I wish you the very best day.